Hi, ladies and gentlemen, this is Wormatty, and today we're testing DR Skibidi Toilet V2B by Onelight. Interesting. Okay, a bit weird. I like the music. Oh, there's a switch there, I didn't see it. Oh, fuck. I accidentally touched the speed lane. How long is this trap going on for? It's like a long time. A player's blocked. I've not seen the Skibidi Toilet videos. I've already seen like a few of them, maybe up to about six. Does this music feature in the videos? Wow. I love that explosion sound. It reminds me of Half-Life. Oh shit. Are they supposed to get out there? Clip your buttons. Put clip brushes over the buttons so you can't get stuck on them. I've moved the speed lane. Oh no, it's alright here. There's potions. I can't see.
It apparently did nothing.
It'd be nice if I could see through this wall as the activator. Maybe you could filter it so that I don't see these wall textures.
It did nothing.
But the red guys do.
That it didn't get enabled or something.
It's good that you've got a motivator announcer sound. Message, sorry. Given the fact that players are still here, I suppose this is a good time for the motivator to start.
Does
that seems a bit unfair.
Cow with a shotgun.
This looks like a very big trap out. Oh.
Wait, is it still going?
Doesn't seem to be making any shotgun sounds. Maybe you want to use some alternative countdown sounds.
Maybe the activator is a bit too fast, like it spawns in way too fast.
Wait, we can break this?
Huh.
Oh, it just leads out to here. What? Oh, and the trap's orderly.
Interesting. Bit of decoration.
Oh. Ow, haha.
Is it possible to oh, it's a disappearing or reappearing, okay. Do I want to know? That's posh. Oh, the frig. Do I jump on these?
Is that Joe Biden?
Maybe make these. I would make these televisions twice the size.
I knew the Skibidi Toilet Creeper thing.
What's that for? Yeah, these televisions are too hard to see. I'd make them larger. Maybe give them a lighting origin as well, so that they're brighter. By that I mean, make a little room away from this one with a light entity in it, and then put a an edict of some kind, like an info teleport destination or an end spark.
What the fuck is
this? And then use that, or a path track.
This makes me want to kill myself.
No, not a path track. Use that as the origin for the lighting on the dynamic props.
Oh my god,
so it takes
the
lighting of another area.
Yaki Gyaram Skibidi Toilet!
Skibidi Toilet! Nilopi Creeper!
Better
another disappearing platform.
Okay,
yeah,
so apparently it gives you a thing
50,
if you go to the right door.
Yeah.
Okay, nothing. I guess it's manually activated trap.
Oh, that was the map stats at first. Oh, you go into a giant toilet. And that's it.
Oh, that's a shame.
Okay, what do we do? Right, let's do left to right then.
And again, Skibidi Run selected.
Incoming.
Oh, you've teleported everyone in the same place.
Oh wait, this changed.
I'll give you a V-script to teleport people into a grid. Where do we go? Oh, over here. That wasn't obvious. You spawn us facing forwards, when we actually have to go right. Also, everyone is alive here and having to go on these tiny platforms. Burt can give you a ladder V-script, by the way. Works like a proper ladder, it's really good. Ah, full damage. What the fuck? Why is it going black? I'm confused.
Pyro, calling here. I need something done. Quietly.
What's that got to do with Skibidi Toilet?
Yeah, I didn't change this part because I thought it was funny, so I just kept it.
Yeah, it definitely is funny.
Let us move.
All right, let's test out everything one by one.
You should move that.
I'll count how many traps there are. 18. Oh.
Huh. Interesting how only the scout died.
I miss.
I could make so if no one is inside this trap, it just goes off instantly.
Oh, there are no trap boundaries on this one.
Yeah, that would make it so...
Unless it's these things.
No, that would be a good improvement.
Maybe a little bit on the...
Because, like, waiting for it...
Maybe a little bit too subtle. But it's not too bad.
Okay, people could just jump through it.
This music's getting on my nerves now.
Thanks, mate.
I feel like the, floor tiles should be lined up with the trap zone.
Yeah, the yellow potion does nothing. It's supposed to do something, but I must have messed it up somehow.
The inclusion of the yellow flashes is good. But, maybe a bit too powerful. What the fuck? You could probably put, like, a particle effect on the end of the gun. a flash, you know, like a weapon muzzle flash.
Big.
Or just make the light radius smaller, because no shotgun would illuminate to that distance. Also, maybe when the cow fires the shotgun, you should, like, shake the cow or something. I think you could apply an impulse to it, make it like a physics...
The Skibidi train!
A constrained physics, or physics thing that's kind of hung in place, and then impart an impulse on it or something. So it kind of like just jumps up slightly every time the shotgun gets fired. Or maybe just a funk door, and you could open it and close it really quickly, and it would look like it's suffering a little bit of recoil. It might look a bit cute. Nice addition of the particles there, of the dust motes.
Wider dancing Gangnam style cats.
Move.
I could turn down the background music a little bit.
Oh wait, where'd he go?
Stupid! Stupid! Stupid!
A silly cat!
Blah! 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 Blah!
Okay, that's a good trap. That's the best one. That's peak.
Good shot! The Skibidi Toilet are creeper! Get some good capture!
A what? Wait, what does this trap do?
I found some
ore. I didn't even see what it did.
Maybe instead of
just
respawning everyone. Have at least like a random dice roll whether or not everyone should be respawned.
Okay, so the spinner is the same, I just changed the background.
So that it's nice when people get respawned, but it's not going to happen all the time. Put people into third person in mini games like this.
Still a banger song.
Maybe I'm foolish, maybe I'm
blind. Speak to me later on and I'll give you a V-script to make it easy. Nice addition of the sound sword effects. Sword sound effect. When somebody gets hit, that's pretty pretty good. Why do I? I'm not quite sure about the choice of music here, but I guess it's a Skibidi toilet thing that I don't understand. Honestly, I'm kind of bored of spinners now. I feel like the spinner is too fast now. Considering that the ground is disappearing underneath us, and the spinner is pretty quick, you don't really get much chance to move over to the other platform. So maybe reduce the speed there. What's the point? Edict's count is fine. 1187 peak with 12 players. Loads of room for more edicts. So you won't have an issue with crashing, thankfully. Quite a lot of network data here. Wonder why. You must have something that's moving. Oh, you've got loads of Fizz bone followers. Go through all your prop dynamic.
Yeah, this is like the only 50-50 I haven't done where you could know which door is the right one. Because it doesn't have an Easter egg or it doesn't tell anyone. So it's just RNG.
Yeah, you gotta decide, Skibidi Toilet or Creeper.
Go through all of the prop dynamics in the map and disable bone followers on them. Because ragdolls spawn bone followers, and bone followers consume edicts, but they also buzz network data that just gets transmitted to clients needlessly. So you don't really need that to be transmitted to clients. It's bad for the server and it's bad for the players. Ideally, there isn't really a need for bone followers at all, so if ever you produce a prop dynamic and it's a ragdoll, just turn off bone follower straight away. You could also modify the FGD so that bone followers is disabled by default.
Simon says next.
Thanks, mate. Thanks, mate. Again, third person would be good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
100 gex.
2. What? Why is it white? This square is green. What? Why are things changing colour? Okay, I find it easier to go to a number because I can imagine a 9-square grid in my head easily. But I think if you're going to use a colour, then your number display at the top should also use the same colour as the platform.
Wait, that's not supposed to be. Where did the middle platform go?
Hang on, if this is Simon Says... Well, that wasn't enough time. This isn't Simon Says, is it?
Platform. It just disappeared. Wait, is it broken?
Hmm.
Wait, it says level 2 again.
Yeah, it said level 2 for the second time.
Yeah, that was
base song choice though. Fucking stupid horse.
Got too fast too quickly. Didn't enjoy the game.
Yeah, that has never happened to me on my own playtests when I do solo.
Also, Simon says, it seems that you don't understand how Simon Says works. It's an old party game. You have one person that says instructions to the room, and they have to say, well,
answer it, dude. Come on.
If the player,
one of them.
if the party
what
host,
are you doing?
Fucking hell. If the host does not say Simon Says, and the player does the action anyway, then they're out of the game.
Oh, hell
they no. must only perform the action when the host says Simon Says. So, for instance, I say Simon Says dance. That means everyone should dance. If they don't dance, they fail. If I say jump up and down, and people jump up and down, they fail because I didn't say Simon Says. And the people who stand still, who don't obey the action, they continue to play. I appreciate you can't really do that in a game without voice lines. And if you use screen text, then it's kind of... it defeats the purpose of the game because people can just see on the screen Simon Says or just Simon doesn't say. But give it a go. You never know. You might be surprised. People might still obey or disobey anyway. But yeah, if you just want to keep like a 9-square game or whatever.
No, I will not.
Then just get rid of the Simon Says name because it's not correct. Call it like Platform Rush or something. Also, I'd maybe make the distance between each of the platforms in that minigame shorter. You see how much network data I was receiving there. I presume it was something like 30 kilobytes per second. Now, I'm only getting 5 kilobytes per second. That's the difference that phone Fizzbone Follower makes. It's a shit ton of network activity. I mean, it's only kilobytes, but still, you know. If you multiply it by the number of players on a server, then it increases the bandwidth requirements on the server. A lot of these spectator cameras don't actually appear to be on the course itself, so... there we go. Yeah, I think your spectator cameras are out of order. The order of the spectator cameras depends on the order in which they were placed into the map and the order that they appear in the VMF. So if you have a set of 10 spectator cameras and they're positioned A, B, C, D in that order in the VMF, then they will... you'll cycle through them A, B, C, D, etc.
Where is he going?
So if you want to ensure that your spectator cameras are in a particular order, then you can edit the VMF in a notepad or a text editor and move them around. To make it easy, you can move your spectator cameras into a separate VMF, copy them all, and do paste special and paste at original location. Save the VMF, delete the spectator cameras from your map, and then import the... we'll add the spectator camera VMF as an instance. Insert a funk instance entity in your map at the origin, and then add that map, and all those cameras will appear in that map. And then you only have to edit the VMF of the spectator camera VMF to change the order, so it'll be a lot easier. And if you give each spectator camera a target name with a number, then you know whether or not you're moving around the correct cameras.
Now someone needs to properly do this trap.
I'm bored of this now. got a quarter of an hour left before I have to go.
So this just is to kill you when you hit the no button?
Yeah, it kills you either way.
Alright, fair. So hitting no is just insta-kill. We'll just instantly kill instead of having the thing. Hey, Will! Incoming! Thanks, Doc.
Yes! Yeah, yeah, thanks! I love this doctor!
Wait. We still have to do following platforms. We still haven't done that one yet.
Yeah, we can't activate the boss.
You've done me proud, boy.
Let's go.
Oh, right, okay.
Oh. Oh, this is from Half-Life, isn't it?
Oh, shit. This is an interesting take on the game. Kind of feels like gambling, but it's still
unless
fun.
Unless the minigame is broken.
Yeah, I think the minigame's broken then. Oh! Oh, I see now.
Pyro, calling here. Fuck's sake, Matthew.
That's it.
Okay.
No! Let's go!
Let us fight man versus Titan!
I found this inside a patient.
Alright, maybe you don't need to put people into third person in that game.
Okay, so how to activate the boss fight? There's like papers with the president names.
Yeah, because I saw something like Trump, Obama, Biden.
You just hit all three of them.
Yeah, thanks, Doc. Alright. So I'm guessing we just do that for this round. Wait, don't find out where the things are.
Okay, so there's one on the breaking platform, like behind you. Yeah, someone found it.
Okay. There doesn't appear to be any indication or score or anything like that that says how many we found.
The next one is right after this teleporter.
Yeah, there's Obama. I think the Trump one's near,
and yeah, the last one is the big toilet.
Okay,
don't go in yet.
Okay, I think, all right, there we go. We got the Trump one. Yep, there we go. That unlocks the boss fight.
It should have an image and everything, but I haven't done that yet.
Oh, it's on.
Why am I a medic?
We got revolver and minigun.
The fuck?
Joe Biden!
I thought it was gonna be easier to hit you. This is so hard.
A pose. Oh, Obama! It's the presidential toilets!
Okay, that laser came out of nowhere.
Oh, I like how the lasers are the America flag colors.
This is too difficult. Don't add lasers and then have, like, multiple crit rockets. You're just going from fairly easy to stupidly hard. You gotta increase the difficulty gradually. Add one mechanic at a time. You're making it far too difficult. People aren't getting to play, so they don't get to experience the fun. You're just catering to, like, people with extreme skill. Or just people who are lucky.
And respawn people, though?
Ouchie.
Ouchie. Oh, we built a wall!
Also, I actually like not having a stupid weapon like this. I enjoy having a shotgun. Oh, it's a stupid spinner. I'm not enjoying having to look up so much and also keep track of the wall. Maybe you could make the wall lower? Why do we all have mediguns? Or do I have a medigun? I don't get it. Weird. It's kind of fun if people...
I like how after I run in, everybody else does.
People only get to use the weapons that they equipped, because that means there's actually a reason to choose decent weapons. The only reason you need weapons in this map is to fight against that boss. So if people... choose heavy because they want the minigun, but they have to sacrifice their speed, then that's balancing.
Alright, I'm just gonna test out the other one.
You could also allow engineers to build sentries, and the sentries could shoot the bosses, but maybe the sentries could, maybe the bosses could also target the sentries as well.
It still does the thing.
So you have, like, limited functionality out of a sentry, for instance.
Oh my god, bro.
You know, all kinds of cool shit. But it's a simple game, so it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, maybe I should add the walls to this trap. Yeah, like invisible walls, or like a glass wall, but it's just like on one of the sides. Wait, there's an error text there?
Wait. Why is he a god mode no clip? Hey, that's cheating!
Hey, Anyway, that's me done.
I would say the playtest was successful. There are some things I have to fix, but overall it kind of works.
Add more silly cats to the map.
More?
Yeah, the silly cats. Yeah, add more. Penis.
Yeah, I can add two cats.
Svenska.
Oppa, Gangnam, stung them.
Okay, I can say one word in Swedish.
What is it?
Okay.